It's me, Umesh. Here we can discuss some important previous question and answers. If you not subscribe the channel, please consider subscribing. Don't forget to press the bell icon.
Friends, today we can discuss some important questions and a related point from gastrointestinal system. So please carefully listen. First question, hiatal hernia is also known as A. inguinal, B. diaphragmatic, C. both A and B, D. abdominal. Correct answer is diaphragmatic. Hiatal hernia is also known as diaphragmatic hernia. Why it is called diaphragmatic hernia? Because in hiatal hernia, the part of stomach pushes up through to the diaphragm. The part of stomach pushes up through the diaphragm. That's why it is called diaphragmatic hernia. Otherwise, hiatal hernia. In hiatal hernia, part of the stomach pushes into the chest cavity. Part of the stomach pushes into the chest cavity. Inguinal hernia, when tissues, example, part of the intestine protrudes through a weak spot in the abdominal muscles. In inguinal hernia, when tissues, example, part of the intestine protrudes through a weak spot in the abdominal muscles. Which is a symptom of duodenal ulcer? Which is a symptom of duodenal ulcer? A. ulceration in stomach. B. patient is generally malnourished. C. food may cause pain. D. food may relieve pain. Correct answer is food may relieve pain. In duodenal ulcer, food may relieve pain. That is the symptom of duodenal ulcer. Food may relieve pain. Helicobacter pylori is the most common cause of gastric and duodenal ulcers. Helicobacter pylori is the most common cause of gastric and duodenal ulcers. The most common complaint is a burning pain in the stomach. The most common complaint is a burning pain in the stomach. Next question. Most common organism involved in peritonitis. A. Streptococci. B. Staphylococci. C. E. coli. D. pneumococci. Correct answer is E. coli. Most common organism involved in peritonitis, E. coli. Streptococci are gram-positive aerobic organism that cause pharyngitis, pneumonia, wound and skin infections. Streptococci are gram-positive aerobic organisms that cause pharyngitis, pneumonia, wound and skin infections. Staphylococci are one of the main agents of nosocomial infections. Staphylococci are one of the main agents of nosocomial infections. What is nosocomial infections? Infection spread from the hospital. That is nosocomial infection. Infection spread from the hospital. That is nosocomial infections. Next question. Most intestinal obstructions occur in A. duodenum, B. ileum, C. jejunum, D. colon. Correct answer is ileum. Most intestinal obstructions occur in ileum. The jejunum and ileum are the distal two parts of the small intestine. The jejunum and ileum are the distal two parts of the small intestine. Duodenum, jejunum and ileum are the parts of small intestine. Duodenum, jejunum and ileum are the smaller parts of small intestine. Here it is jejunum and ileum situating. Duodenum is here. So this is the upper portion. Duodenum is the upper portion. Jejunum and ileum are the lower portion of the small intestine. So you can see the gallbladder here and stomach. Gastrin and HCl juices are inside the stomach. Here it is esophagus. Esophagus is the food pipe. So next question. Diverticulitis is most common in A. transverse colon, B. ascending colon, C. descending colon, D. sigmoid colon. Correct answer is sigmoid colon. Diverticulitis is most common in sigmoid colon. Here is the picture. You can understand from this picture easily. Ascending colon, here the very near to the cecum ascending colon is going upward, that is it's called ascending colon, then transverse colon, then descending colon coming downwards, that is descending colon. This part is sigmoid colon. Sigmoid colon is here. So diverticulitis is most occur in this part, because in diverticulitis the colon portions will bulge like a pouch. In diverticulitis colon portions will bulge like a pouch. So here is the rectum portion, anus. So this is the picture of large intestine. So ascending colon coming up and transverse colon, descending colon coming downwards, and this is the sigmoid colon. This part is diverticulitis common in this sigmoid colon. Next question: ineffectual straining of stool is known as A. Borborygmi, B. Constipation, C. Steatorrhea, D. Tenesmus. Correct answer is tenesmus. Ineffectual straining of stool is known as tenesmus. Borborygmi. What is borborygmi? A gurgling noise made by the movement of fluid and gas in the intestine. A gurgle noise made by the movement of fluid and gas in the intestine, that is borborygmi. What is steatorrhea? Oily stools which often float. Steatorrhea is an oily stools which often float. Next question: complication of splenectomy. A. cholecystitis, B. pancreatitis, C. appendicitis, D. gastritis. Correct answer is pancreatitis. Complication of splenectomy is pancreatitis. Complication of splenectomy is pancreatitis. Spleen. It helps fight infection and filters damaged blood cells from your blood. Function of spleen are helps to fight infection and filters damaged blood cells from your blood. Function of spleens are fight infection and filters damaged blood cells from your blood. Cholecystitis. What is cholecystitis? Inflammation of the gallbladder. Cholecystitis is the inflammation of gallbladder. Next question: the nurse should assess the client with cirrhosis of liver and hepatic coma for A. uremia, B. urticaria, C. icterus, D. anemia. Correct answer is icterus. The nurse should assess the client with cirrhosis of liver and hepatic coma for icterus. Icterus, also known as jaundice. Icterus, also known as jaundice. Yellow skin caused by the accumulation of bilirubin in the blood. Icterus, also known as jaundice. Yellow skin caused by the accumulation of bilirubin in the blood. Urticaria, other name is hives. Urticaria, other name is hives. Skin rash triggered by a reaction of food, medicine or other irritants. Urticaria, other name is hives. Skin rash triggered by a reaction to food, medicine or other irritants. Next question: functions of stomach are, except A. temporary storage of food, B. absorption of food, C. digestion of food, D. production of intrinsic factor. Correct answer is absorption of food. Absorption of food is not a function of stomach. Food absorption mostly taking place from the small intestine. Food absorption mostly taking place from the small intestine. Nutrients and minerals absorption found in food. Nutrients and mineral absorption found in food. This absorption, nutrients and mineral absorption taking place from the small intestine. Nutrients and mineral absorption taking place from the small intestine. What are the functions of stomach? Food stores 3 to 4 hours. Functions of stomach are food storage 3 to 4 hours. Formation of chyme. Chyme is food plus gastric juice. Chyme means food plus gastric juice. So formation of chyme, food storage 3 to 4 hours. Then production of intrinsic factor, a glycoprotein required for absorption of B12. Production of intrinsic factor, a glycoprotein required for absorption of vitamin B12. Functions of stomach are food storage 3 to 4 hours, formation of chyme, production of intrinsic factor, a glycoprotein required for absorption of vitamin B12. Next, bile is A. acidic, B. basic, C. neutral, D. has no pH. Correct answer is basic. Bile is basic. What are the functions of bile? Acid fat absorption. Inhibits bacterial growth in small intestine. Neutralizes gastric acid in the small intestine. Aids excretion of bilirubin. What are the functions of bile? Acid fat absorption. Acid fat absorption. Inhibits bacterial growth in small intestine. Inhibits bacterial growth in small intestine. Neutralizes gastric acid in the small intestine. Neutralizes gastric acid in the small intestine. Aids excretion of bilirubin. Aids excretion of bilirubin. Next, three questions are related from microbiology. So, who is the father of modern microbiology? A. Robert Koch, B. Van Leeuwenhoek, C. Louis Pasteur, D. Lister. Correct answer is Van Leeuwenhoek. Antony Van Leeuwenhoek is the father of modern microbiology. Robert Koch is the father of bacteriology. Robert Koch is the father of bacteriology. Joseph Lister is the father of antiseptic surgery. Joseph Lister is the father of antiseptic surgery. First person to view microorganism is Antony Van Leeuwenhoek. First person to view microorganism is Antony Van Leeuwenhoek. He is also the father of modern microbiology. Antony Van Leeuwenhoek is also father of modern microbiology, and he is the first person to view microorganism, that is Antony Van Leeuwenhoek. Edward Jenner developed the smallpox vaccine. Edward Jenner developed a smallpox vaccine. 12th question. First drug discovered to treat leprosy is A. rifampicin, B. clofazimine, C. ethambutol, D. dapsone. Correct answer is dapsone. First drug discovered to treat leprosy is dapsone. Rifampicin is an antibiotic used to treat TB. Rifampicin is an antibiotic used to treat TB. Clofazimine is an antibiotic used for the treatment of Mycobacterium avium complex infection. Clofazimine is an antibiotic used for the treatment of Mycobacterium avium complex MAC infection. Mycobacterium avium complex MAC infection. Ethambutol is an antibiotic used to prevent growth of TB. Ethambutol is an antibiotic used to prevent growth of TB. Rifampicin is an antibiotic used to treat TB. Clofazimine is an antibiotic used for the treatment of Mycobacterium avium complex infection. Ethambutol is an antibiotic used to prevent growth of TB. Who developed electron microscope? A. Tort, B. Robert Hooke, C. Noll and Ruska, D. Robert Bond. Correct answer is Noll and Ruska. Who developed electron microscope? Noll and Ruska developed electron microscope. Tort was a bacteriologist, discovered bacteriophages. Tort was a bacteriologist, discovered bacteriophages. Bacteriophages is a type of virus that infects bacteria. Bacteriophages is a type of virus that infects bacteria. So, thanks for watching. Please consider subscribing. Don't forget to press the bell icon. Please select all option in bell icon.